Now, one of North Africa's most famous dishes is, of course, the tagine, and it comes from the shape of the dish that you cook it in. And this is generally what they all look like. Always made out of clay, sometimes clay and then glazed, and generally in this shape with a flat bottom. They cook on a wooden fire underneath, and always with a domed roof. And the domed roof has a purpose. It's to keep the condensation in there, to allow the condensation to drip down the side, inside, to keep the stew nice and moist. So rather than it just cook with a lid. Well, I'm going to do a lamb tagine here. First, cut the leg of lamb into inch pieces, or you could use ready-diced stewing lamb. To make the paste, you want about a tablespoon of coriander. We've got about a tablespoon of cumin, together with the same amount of turmeric and this wonderful paprika. Now, the paprika is really special over here. It's that lovely deep red in colour. I'm going to mix that into a sort of a spice mix, together with some harissa. Now, the way that they make this is basically chili. It's almost like rocket fuel, to be honest, but it's red chilies mixed with garlic and oil, and you get different strengths of harissa. And give that a quick mix with some olive oil, just to create a little paste. You can make it yourself, but it's much, to be honest, easier to buy. And you've got this lovely paste that we've got here. And then add our lamb to this paste. And give this a mix. Hot pan on the stove, some olive oil, and I want to colour the lamb just slightly before I add it to our pot. And to help the colour, I'm going to use some tomato puree. It just helps give it that nice, rich, dark colour which I want in my tagine. So while that's cooking, I'm going to grab some onion. You want to keep the vegetables quite large because you want them to cook in the same time as the lamb, but you don't want them to fall apart. So I'm going to add the onions now over the top. You take quite a bit of garlic, this, roughly 3 cloves. But they're going to cook down nicely with that lamb. Now, I'm using fresh tomatoes. You could, of course, use tinned tomatoes. But if you are going to replace the fresh tomatoes, you want about sort of 3 tins of tomatoes for this. So our lamb's sealed nicely. In we go with the tomatoes. Quick start. So now we can finish this off. We've got some whole apricots, some lovely sultanas, and dates, of course. And then I'm going to use some almonds, because the mixture of nuts and dried fruit in a tagine, I think, are really vital. It incorporates that nice flavour and sweetness. And another way of getting sweetness into it is using some honey. Just some runny honey over the top. I'm going to count in one of these. This is a little star anise or aniseed, so popular around here, of course, the aniseed flavour. And then finally, some water. You want the water about halfway up the meat, no more than that. If you put too much in, it's going to become too liquid. So when it's come to the boil, just take this off and then place our tagine on the heat. And then all we do is take our mixture. All it's done is just come up to the boil and pour it into our tagine, like that. Place the lid on. I'm going to leave that to cook for about sort of 45 minutes. In the meantime, I'm going to serve it with tabouleh. Tabouleh is a Lebanese salad made from bulgur wheat with lots of fresh herbs. Pre-soak the bulgur wheat and add plenty of chopped coriander, flat leaf parsley and mint. Now, I actually use about 1/3 herbs, 2/3 bulgur wheat. Next, to tie in with the fruit theme, I'm going to add some fresh apricots, but you could use dried. And then I love plenty of lemon juice. I go on about half a lemon per person. Salt, black pepper, and a good slug of olive oil. Mix all this together. And you've got a simple little fruit tabouleh. Goes fantastically well with that tagine. After about an hour, the tagine is almost ready. I'm going to finish it off with some chickpeas. I didn't put these in at the beginning, otherwise they'll start to sort of disintegrate while it's cooking. But if we lift off our tagine, check that out. Throw in the herbs, throw in the chickpeas. A quick stir, some seasoning, and it's ready to serve. And there we have it, my Moroccan-style lamb tagine with a lovely apricot tabouleh while overlooking Marseille. Easy as that. I'm heading to La Maison du Pastis, which stocks over 95 types, including 6 homemade versions. What a fantastic shop. Incredible. And the smell. Pastis is an aniseed-based spirit. The main flavouring comes from star anise and licorice, but it can contain up to 56 herbs and spices, including coriander, fennel and cardamom. The owner, Frédéric Bénard, is keen for me to try one of his homemade blends.
First, one part of pastis.
Yeah.
Not too much. We need water.
Okay.
Because...
We definitely need water, because it's yes. about between 40% and 60% alcohol. That's why we need water. Go on, then. When you dilute it with water, it famously turns cloudy, as the decrease in alcohol causes some of the ingredients to become insoluble. It's light.
No? It's not aggressive.
It's very delicate, but it's
if you want to...
lots of spice, lots of flavour, lots of...
Yes.
Certainly aniseed. Now, if I wanted one to cook with, what would I look for?
I have one cuvée, la cuvée yeah. spéciale, with okay. Armoise Dominant, same family as Absinthe.
I'm going to take a yes. bottle of that then, please. Merci.
Thank you very
Merci,
much.
Monsieur.
Allez.
Au revoir.
Bye-bye. Welcome in Marseille.
Now, Frédéric assures me that this is the pastis that I'm supposed to be cooking with, so slightly milder and not so alcoholic as the rest of the stuff he's got in there. And I thought a great combination to go with it would be some vegetables and a lovely piece of mackerel. Wonderful fish, especially when you catch it so close to the ocean, because it really does need to be as fresh as possible. Now, it's one of the easiest fish to fillet, mackerel. Just insert the knife underneath. You don't need to mess around with the knife, and the fillets just come straight off. Now, to take the bones out, what I'm going to do is create a little V-shaped cut either side of the bone and then lift out the meat. You do lose a little bit of the meat, but on something this size, it's not going to make any difference. I've just got a selection of lovely sort of market veg, some carrots, some courgettes, onion, and a little fennel, touch of garlic. And all we need to do is just peel these. And the reason why I peel them rather than sort of slice them is that it's quite quick to cook. And if you cut them too thick, the fish will be cooked before the veg. I'm going to just use some brown paper. And this is just normal greaseproof paper, which we can cut into sort of a large oblong. And then we can take some of our veg. We've got our onion, a bit of fennel, some carrot, and some of the courgette. A little parsley in the centre. Then grabbing our fish, place that on the top. Seasoning, salt and pepper. A piece of lemon. Some of these fennel tops. And we can put some basil, a bit of parsley, whatever you want really, but just something simple like that. And all we do now is fold this over. Basically, to make the parcel, to hold in all that flavour, what you do is you start at one end and you just crimp this all the way around, leaving a little gap in here. We can then grab our pastis and fill. You want about 50 to 75 mils of pastis in there. You could, of course, use some white wine. You can either cook these about 8 minutes in the oven, 200 degrees centigrade. Alternatively, you can put them straight on a pan, like that. No need to put any water, no oil. Pop it in a dry pan, place the lid on, and cook that now for about 6 to 7 minutes. You can then lift this out, or come straight out of the oven, and it can be just served. And the best part about this is leaving it in the packet. And when your guests want to dive in, grab a knife, literally open it up. And they say if it looks good, it's going to taste good. And how good does that look?